meal.
Journey to this wonderful and colorful world of birds, and we hope that you will leave the show full of ways by our bird conservation champions and be inspired to take actions for all our feathered friends around the world. Now, speaking of feathered friends, I'm pretty sure all of you have seen some chickens on stage, right? Yes? Well, those are our Bantam chickens, and with it, we have one more chicken joining us. So everyone, keep your eyes at their balcony. Let's welcome Chucky, our Bantam rooster. Chucky! And a perfect touchdown! Can we give Chucky a round of applause to everyone? Good job, Chucky! Now, many of you might think that chickens cannot fly, but Chucky has proven otherwise, okay? Chucky, time for you to head back home. Time to be distracted today. Can we give him a big hand, everyone? Good job, Chucky! Right now, we are going to highlight the natural behaviors of macaws. Now, macaws in the wild love to congregate on palm trees to feast on fruits and nuts. So if you look right up there, we have attached some fruits and nuts for the birds. So everyone, turn your heads back there. Let's welcome Gaia, our hyacinth macaw! They can be found in the jungles of South America. Now going back to Gaia. Gaia here is our hyacinth macaw, and she is one of the four blue macaw species that can be found in the world. And right here in the bird park, we have three of them on exhibit, so do head down to the parrot paradise to visit them, okay? Now after feasting, these birds, they are going to fly to rocky areas just like this to lick up on clay or chalk, and this will help in any of digestions of any unripe palm nuts or fruits that they have eaten. Now, looks like Adric is still up there, but not to worry. This will definitely be your next stop. Hi, Azar. Who do we have here?
Now, this, everyone, is EPA Scarlet Macaw. Now, EPA is Jurong Birds Park's Gold Green for Wildlife Ambassador. EPA is so environmentally conscious that he will only use reusable cups, containers and utensils.
You look very confused.
Yes.
Okay, let me explain. Yeah, let's say you are a drink seller.
Alright, nice head. Thanks, Azar.
Now, if you were to give Ify a plastic cup to drink from, he will not use that cup.
Okay, I do have a single-use plastic cup with me right here.
This is what I'm talking about. The single-use disposable plastic cup. Okay, watch. Ify, Howard has given you a plastic cup to drink from.
And Ify returns me the plastic cup! Look at that!
But that's not all. Let's say you give him a reusable cup this time, but it has a plastic straw. You know what? He will not use the straw.
Okay, I don't believe you, Azar, but I do have something like this.
Okay, you don't believe? We shall see. Watch, everyone. Hawa and Ify, Hawa has given you a plastic straw.
Is it going to happen? And look at that, Ify returns me the plastic straw.
Okay, so how is he going to drink without a straw? Everyone, look, get your cameras ready. Watch.
Oh, look at that. Ify drinks straight from the cup.
Good job, Ify, good job. Now, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, plastic has invaded our waters to such an extent that by the year 2050, there will be more plastic than fish in our oceans. In fact, plastic is known to kill more than a million animals and fish every single year. That is why plastic is the deadliest monster in our oceans.
Oh no, that is such an alarming great. Now we should all help to fight these deadliest monsters by reducing single-use plastic. Just like EP, we should refuse plastic straws and plastic cups by bringing our own reusable cups and containers when we buy takeaway food and drinks. And we should also avoid using single-use plastic bags by bringing our own reusable bag when we go shopping.
Ah, that's a good idea. Look. I also brought my own bag. Come, put your head inside.
Asa, this is a single-use plastic bag.
Yeah, but I'm reusing.
No, you're supposed to use a reusable bag just like this, okay?
Okay, we'll use your reusable bag.
Okay, let me help you with that. And in goes the hat. Can we give Ippy and Asa a round of applause? And Asa,
yes,
you are supposed to reuse this bag, okay?
Okay.
Thank you. Now for the next act, we'll be joined by two beautiful birds. So during this act, I need your cooperation to please remain seated at all times and hands down when the birds are flying, okay? Yes? Okay. Okay, alright, now look like our first volunteer is in position. Everyone keep your eyes at that hut. Let's welcome our beautiful turtle toucans. There are two of them. Where's the other one? Alright, there we are. Come on. Okay, we have a very brave young volunteer this afternoon. Can we give him a big hand, everyone? Good job, young man. Now these are turtle toucans. Sorry, do not touch the birds. Please, thank you. Now these are Toko toucans. They are the largest in the toucan family, easily recognizable by their bright and orange bills. Now to demonstrate how agile these birds are, the toucans are going to fly to our center volunteer animal. And Sheena, she will be making her way to the center volunteer and will be tossing two pieces of fruit way up high. So let us see if the toucans can catch it, okay? Our center volunteer, please do not move. Thank you. Alright. Okay. Sheena, are you ready? Yes, okay. 1, 2, 3. Yay! That was a great catch. We have one toucan. Can we all count together? Come on. 1, 2, 3. And that was a great catch by our toucan. Good job, guys. But did you know the population number in the wild are declining due to poaching and deforestation? Now if you can, please support your local conservation programs. Now with me I have Mrs. Axel. Right there is Mr. Axel. Hi Mr. Axel, you want to join your wife right here? Come on. He's ignoring his wife. Mr. Axel, come on, join your wife right here. Turn around, join your wife. Come here. There you go. Now these are our husband and wife team. They've done a fantastic job this afternoon. Come on, right here. This afternoon, and it's time for them to head back home. And they are very loyal to one another. So when one goes, the other will follow. So everyone watch this, okay? I'm going to place them on the stump right here. Usually, Mrs. Axel leads the way. Mr. Axel follows our Toko toucans, everyone! Now, what differentiates parrots from other animals is their ability to process sounds, and they do this in the wild as a form of social communication. The yellow-maned Amazon parrot is famous for its ability to copy human sounds, and we have one such bird today. So everyone, get your video cameras ready, okay? Let's start with something simple, shall we? Do you want to say a nice hello? Hello! Hello! Now introduce yourself. Tell everyone here your name.
Amigo!
Did you catch that? His name is Amigo. We'll do this one more time, okay? What's your name?
Amigo!
Amigo is his name. Amigo, there are so many people out here. How else would you like to greet all these nice people?
How?
English.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
zero. And he's a veteran here at the venture department. Now, John, you want to look in front? Sit in front. Come on. You want to say hello to everyone? Say hello. Say hello. You want to need a microphone? Say hello. Lexi doesn't want to say hello, but that's okay. John, you just stay right here. We're going to continue with Amigo, okay? Okay, now earlier on, you heard Amigo count in English. Now this time, he's going to count in a different language, and that will be in Chinese.
Extremely loud, okay?
Now it's time for Amigo here to head back home, but before that, can all of you wave to goodbye, Amigo?
Bye!
Bye-bye!
Bye-bye!
Bye-bye! Amigo, all yellow leaf and the zone carrot. Good job, Amigo! Now I do have to emphasize this once again that birds like Amigo, they are very hard to upkeep and they are known to live as long as you and I. So do think twice or even thrice before getting yourself a pet parrot. And the next two birds that joining us are going to show us how loving hornbills can be. So with that, everyone turn your heads back down. Let's welcome Vicky, authored by Hornbill. Hello, Vicky. I'm Vicky and myself becoming close to some of you. I need all of you to please remain seated at all times, okay? Now hornbills like Vicky, they can be found in Asia, but hornbills in general, they can be found in two continents of the world, Asia and Africa. Now when a female hornbill wants to nest, they will look for holes or cavities in trees. So if you look right up there, now that nest box is similar to the nest boxes that we give our hornbills right here in the bird park. Now Vicky and myself are coming up this flight of stairs. I need all of you to please remain seated at all times. Please sit down. Yes, I need the kids to remain seated, please. Thank you. Let's go a bit higher, Vicky. Okay. All the people out there, big bird, isn't she? Okay. Now Vicky, we're in position. Check out this box. Vicky, your nest box is to your right. Hop a little. Come on. Should I make it hop? One more time. Okay. Now what Vicky is doing right now is she's inspecting the interior of the nest box. And only if she likes it, then she will hop right in. And in she goes. Now once inside, she will then seal herself using soil, regurgitated food, and even her own droppings. Now the hole will only be big enough for her bait to stick up. So Vicky, if you like the nest box, you can seal it up now. Oh! Vicky, are you still inside? There she is, everyone! Turn your heads back there. Let's welcome Sunny! Oh great, by Hornbill! Jurong Bird Park's animal icon. Now this is what happens in the wild. The male will go out to find food to feed the female for about 3 to 4 months, and afterwards mother and child will leave the nest. Now right here in the bird park, we have been successful in breeding or rental pied hornbills using nest boxes just like this, and thanks to your contribution to our conservation fund, we have released some of them into nature reserves and also right here in the bird park. Now look at that! Beautiful wingspan, Sunny! Now if you'd like to see more hornbill species like Sunny or Vicky and toucans like Mr. and Mrs. Axel, you can head down to the Toucans and Hornbills exhibit. It's just right in front there, okay? You can see how big they are, how beautiful they are, okay? And I see Azza on stage calling Sunny down. Are you here to call Sunny down? And there you go, hornbills, everyone! Take off first. Oh. And up goes Vega! your bird is in sharp eyesight, please help the birds.